This is the manager speaking.
This is the World Trade Center.
I'll pass you on.
This is the manager speaking.
How can I help?
This is the World Trade Center.
I'll pass you on.
This is the manager speaking.
Thank you for calling.
A natural or man-made hazard resulting in substantial physical or emotional damage.
In the next 20 minutes, you'll be experiencing some real-life disasters.
So sit back
and prepare yourself.
Disasters!
Are you two still with me?
Yes, I'm over here.
Yes, I am down here. Guys, heads down, need to find the dog.
Okay. I'll look this way.
I'll go look over here.
Okie dokie.
Can you two see anything?
I see nothing.
No, it's too dark.
Wait, I see something that way.
I'll go look over here. I think I can get a closer look.
Yeah, me too.
Okie dokie.
I think I see something moving over there.
Wait, you guys. I can feel something breathing down my neck. How big is your dog?
It's a flower.
Nikolai?
Doggy.
Steven! We have lost Nikolai.
I can't see anything out here.
Oh, okay, you look for the dog. I look for the guy.
Okay, I think I'll look over here.
Doggy.
Nikolai! Doggy!
I found Nikolai. Nikolai, stop touching my feet.
Oh. Where is the doggy? I found him! I found the dog! Hello? Is anybody there?
Ah! 800,000 people are reported missing each year. Half are suspected to be abduction.
Come on, the other one.
Surgery clinic. Do you want to be physically different? Do you want better lips? Bigger boobs? Or a J-Lo ass? Well, come to Dr. Dangerous today. Call 0800-429-827. That's 24 on the high street. Why don't we meet some of my patients?
Oh.
How are you, Gemma?
I'm fabulous.
And how's the surgery treating you, honey?
Oh, Dr. Danger, I go around Liverpool and everyone's just like Gemma. Lay me out a smacker on those lips, and I'm like, no, stand away. So they blow me a kiss instead. And I blow one back.
Well, you look gorgeous, darling.
I know.
Why don't we be my next patient? Come out here, my family.
Oh. Hello, Dr. Danger.
And so, how are the boobs treating you, honey?
Do you know what, Ned? Before I came to see you, everybody around the valley was saying, my family! You're a pancake of a woman, not like your mother. And I'd say, I know it. Do you know what I fed up? So I come to see you, 20 quid later, massive boobs. Now everybody around the corner goes, oh, look at them boobs.
Oh, look at them boobs.
Oh, look at them boobs. They're fabulous.
They are absolutely fantastic, darling.
Thanks, doctor.
And how about my last patient? How are you, sugar?
Well, since I got these butt implants, everybody says I look like Beyonce. And it's really made a big impact if you know what I mean.
I certainly do, darling. That's disgusting.
Doctor, I'm not being funny. I'm in agony. I don't need the doctor. My voice is gone. I don't think it's going to be a disaster.
What? This is a disaster.
This is a disaster.
Botox is the most common surgery, but eyelid surgery is the most common one to go wrong.
Hello, darling. How are you?
Oh, here again.
Oh, honey, you can't be leaving the lights on like this.
Oh, Gerald, I'm working.
But, honey, we can't be spending money on electricity willy-nilly.
Oh! You want to start talking about wasting money now, do you?
Where's this going, darling?
Would you like to explain this to me?
Well, it appears to be a receipt for a yacht.
Oh, yacht what? Yacht what?
Well, it must have been one of those gala evenings of some sort, you know? We're out on the pier, we're drinking champagne, there's a silent auction, and, you know, we do it all to care about the kids, you know?
When have you ever cared about the kids?
I have to pretend to. I've got to make an appearance at these things, darling.
Gerald, we can't start spending money like this.
Well, maybe we shouldn't spend money on all that slim fast for you, darling.
Slim fast? But 1,000 calories in one day. I don't use slim fast anymore, Gerald.
Try telling that to your thighs.
Maybe you shouldn't be spending them on those little blue pills.
Those are for the both of us, darling.
Well,
if you know
stop wasting your money. You're just in a bad lover.
Well, at least I'm not a terrible mother.
Too far this time now, Geraldine.
No.
I'm taking the table with me.
But darling, no. It was just banter. You can't leave me. Do you want some help there, darling?
No, I am now an independent woman that doesn't need any man.
But are you sure? You seem to be struggling quite a bit.
My mother was right. I only married you for the money.
But darling, you can't leave me with the kids. I don't like them.
Either do I. They look like you.
50% of all marriages end in divorce.
Don't bother.
This is a man who drinks whiskey and gin to set him on his way and put him in a spin.
This is a man who once hit his wife. What a mistake to make in one's life.
Hanashinana mana, hola kagana kokana, she's a
Oh, she said I'm perfect. She's my favourite. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I know their language. I'm going in. I should be running into like a...
We had to leave two of my kids back home with my brother. We can't afford to take everyone away. But Jeffrey, he loves acting. So we thought we'd take him to Hollywood, you know, see the sights. But we can't anymore. Because then it happened.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I can have your attention, please. I'm about to go through the safety procedures. In case of an emergency, your exits are here, here, and here. In case of lack of oxygen, yellow oxygen masks will be released from the overhead bin above you. To secure, pull the mask towards you and place over your nose and mouth and pull strap over your head. Please secure your own before helping others. In case of a water landing, life jackets are located under your seats. Place vest over your head and secure straps around your waist. To inflate, pull the red toggle. Thank you for your attention and we wish you a good flight on American Airlines. Thank you.
George, and I'm 27 years old, and I'm going to LA with my fiancé. We're getting married next month, and I finally get everything I've ever wanted. The man of my dreams, the fairy tale wedding. I wanted this from when I was so young, but now it's all been taken away from me. Nothing good ever happens anymore, because then it happened.
Thank you. My name's Nellie Casey and I'm 32. I was on my way to LA on like kind of a business trip, but it was more of an opportunity really. I live back in Sheffield, England, with my 1-year-old. And, you know, I wouldn't say we have the worst life, but we live in a 1-bedroom flat on a council estate, and it was more to make her life better, to make her have the things that I didn't have. But for people like me, chances get taken away from you as quickly as they come. And now my daughter's not gonna have the life that I dreamed of. She's gonna grow up in a crappy town and have a crappy job like everybody else on that estate. All because this happened. 3,000 people died that day and I was one of them.
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 Linda George, 1984 to 2001. Juliana McCourt, 1997 to 2001.
Brian Dale, 1960 to 2001.
Nellie Casey, 1969 to 2001.
A natural or man-made hazard, resulting in substantial physical or emotional damage.
In the last 20 minutes, you've experienced some real-life disasters.
Just sit back
and take it in.
Disasters.